Good morning, children. See, today we are discussing about the animal kingdom. So the part animal kingdom, the last part. Animal kingdom. See, my dear children. Here we have discussed before that there are two types we are having ants. One is vertebrates and another one is invertebrates. What is the first one? Vertebrates. And next one is the invertebrates. So we have discussed about the invertebrates first. What is that? The group of snails, slugs. We have discussed about the group of snails, slugs, squids, etc. And one more that we have discussed about the group of insects like millipedes and centipedes. Like millipedes, centipedes, and butterfly. About the butterfly, those we have discussed, means like a pupa. So next we have come to the vertebrates. Vertebrates means what I am told? The animals which are having the bone and skull. So means bone means it means that the backbone. So the animals which are having backbone, those we are calling as vertebrates. The animals which are not having those, that we call as invertebrates. We have discussed about the invertebrates animals. So we are discussing about the vertebrates. Already in vertebrates we have discussed about what are the things we have discussed with the vertebrates. About fish. And next one is first one is a fish, and second one is we have discussed about the amphibians. And third still we are having. So first one fish, next one is the amphibians. These two we have completed about fish and amphibians. Next is what we are having, reptiles. And fourth one is birds. And fifth one is that mammals. So today in this session we are going to discuss about reptiles, birds and mammals. So children, reptiles, you may have listened that. Reptiles. See, if you see the reptiles, what are the animals we used to call reptiles? Yes, reptiles means like examples we can say that snakes, crocodiles, tortoise and turtles. These we can call it as a reptile. So what we call these reptiles. So snakes, crocodiles, tortoise, turtles, etc. So these are nothing but these snakes, crocodiles, tortoise, and turtles are comes under the which type? Reptiles comes under this reptiles group. If you see crocodile, if you observe, or else if you observe that snakes, you can observe their body is used to cover with the scales. You can observe that there will be like a scales. See crocodile, like this scales used to be there on their body. So what is the use of that scales? It will be protect and it gives a better grip. It gives a better grip to them to move from one place to another place, and also it will be protects their body. So it will be hard and sharp. Hard and sharp, there will be a scales presenting on the body. If you see snake. reptiles, you can see that these used to be lives in the water. Where these used to be lives in the water? Where these used to be lives, ma? In the water. These used to write important points, my dear children. These used to, or these lives in water. And one more point is that reptiles is used to lay eggs. They won't give birth to their children, not like us. See, if human beings, if you observe human beings or pets, dogs, cats, if you see, they used to give birth like their same resembles with them. So how we are there? We are having two hands and two legs, one head. So to which baby we are giving birth, the baby also will be have the same, as looking like the same of the parent. If you see, the dog also used to give birth to the another dog which is look like their likes its parent. So but here if you see, in these reptiles, these won't give directly birth to the same resemblance of their parent. These used to lay the eggs. How it will give birth to the children? These used to lay the eggs. After that it will be hatched. So these lays eggs. So then what happened? From the egg, it is slowly, what happened by eating, it used to be hatches. And whenever it lays the eggs, it won't take care of those eggs. Just it leaves that and it comes out. And snakes, up to some time these used to be take care, but afterwards they won't be feed anything. Just they used to leave them and they used to come out that. And you can see these reptiles having the, I told that these are concentric vertebrates, it means that these are having lungs to breathe also. So it breathe, these breathes, these are breathing through their lungs. These are breathing through their lungs. So this is about the reptiles. So the reptiles is having the, yes, it is those used to live in the water. Shall I erase it, ma? So next part is that birds. If you see birds, how the birds used to be looks like, ma? Birds. If you see the birds used to be, it is used to fly. Yes, no? No other animal is having that special category that it can fly. So the bird is can able to fly in the air easily. Why? Because of its hollow bones, and if it is hollow bones, it will be lightweight. Hollow means inside there will be a space. If bone actually, see, if you look this chalk piece, it is not a hollow, because inside also there will be a piece, chalk pieces. If you see an empty water bottle or else an empty pen refill, so if you see through that refill, with a full ink refill, if you see, there will be a presence of ink in that, then we cannot say that it is hollow if there is no ink. So only the refill is there, so then it will be a hollow, means inside nothing will be there. It is a hollow and it will be looks a very lightweight also. So same as like that, the birds is having its bones, hollow bones, and it is due to that hollow bones, their body will be lightweight and they can fly easily in the air. And see, we are having, actually the birds are not having any limbs. We are having limbs means legs and hands, but the birds are not having any limbs. It's a four limbs means a front limbs is modifying as a, how we are having four limbs hands, no, but the birds four limbs are modified as a wings. The birds four limbs are modifying as a wings. So with that wings, it is used to, Yeah, it is used to flutter its wings and it can fly in the, it can fly high in the sky because of it, when it is fluttering, it is pushing the air in the downward. Then the reverse action, the air will pushes their body in the upward direction so that it can able to fly in the air easily. And you can see, so what is the first point now? These bones are hollow. Bones are hollow and lightweight, so that it can able to fly in the air. It can fly easily, and also it is also breathing through the lungs itself. The birds also, see, you can see that it is having a very strong muscle. It is having very strong muscle, so that with that strong muscle, it is a fluttering, and also it is compared to us, it is having very good sense of smell. Compared to us, it is having very good sense of smell. Not only birds, many of animals, even dogs, also having a very sharp sense of smell. And the birds can able to see the, or see, you can, when you are looking, you just able to see only 180 degrees only. When you are standing straightly, you can able to see only 180 degrees. You can't able to see the remaining 180 degrees. But the birds can able to see most out of 360 degrees, it can able to see nearly the 270 degrees. So that's what it is, very difficult to catch the bird. Understand ma? It's very difficult to catch the bird. See, we are eating the food with the teeth, no? But the birds are not having any teeth. It is used to, when it is pick up the food, it is used to send to the stomach. So the food is chewing by the stomach only. So that is nothing but we call gizzard. That's something nothing but we call gizzard. The food is chewing in the stomach. Like us, the bird also used to take breath through the nostrils only. And also, the difference between the reptiles and birds is that the birds used to give birth to their, it is also used to lay eggs, but it is used to take care of them up to after the chicks hatches also, the parent bird used to take care of that children only. Their chicks it is used to take care up to when it grows up, it is used to take care of, the parent used to take care of their children only. But if you see the reptiles, it won't take care of that. It just lays and up to sometime it will be with them and it will be left them. But the birds are very caring parents like us, like human beings. So it is used to feed them up to growing of them, and it is used to give a shelter. And when it lays eggs, it is used to stay on the eggs to give warmness to their eggs. It is used to sit on their eggs itself. So these are very caring parents. So still some of the points I did not write. You are listening, you know, you have to write. Okay, ma'am? So next one is that, what is the last one, my dear children? Yeah, mammals. The fifth one is that, mammals. What is the mammals? You can know, you can find that mammals means like the animals which are feeding. The animals which are grows by feeding the mother's milk. The animals which are growing by feeding their mother's milk. That type of animals we call mammals. What we call, ma? The animals. What is mammals? The animals which grow up. Mammals that grow up. Feeding. Up there. So that type of animals we call mammals. Maximum mammals means the human beings also, we are just growing by feeding our mother milk only. So we are also comes under the mammals. And you can see human beings, next still our pets. Most of the pets like a dog and next cow and a goat. So these are all and a cat. So human beings, dogs, pets like dogs, cats and farm animals, farm animals are comes under the mammals. So these mammals also, how they used to give, they won't lay the eggs. So these mammals can't lay the eggs. It gives birth. Children like the exact copies of them. So how the parent will be there, as like the same the looking appearance will be for their children also, like exact copies of them. They used to give birth to their children and they used to feed the milk up to their growing. And also see, but only one, the very rare mammals only used to lay the eggs. So here can we can write this one will lay the eggs, because some of the mammals also, some of the mammals they used to lay eggs also, like a platypus. Platypus moment. It is in Australia. It is used to lay eggs. So very rare this type of platypus mammals only used to lay the eggs. Remaining all are used to give the remaining all mammals used to give birth to their children as an eggs or the copies of them. So this type of the mammals used to have this type of characteristics. And also you can see that the mammals, actually the mammals used to have, their body used to cover with the hair. So due to that hair, they can able to keep their body to be warm and they can protect their body from the coolness also. So when we are, when in the winter season, when we are feeling the cool, we used to cover our body with the sweaters, no? So for them, like a monkey, so their body is used to covers with the feather, covers with the hair, so they can protect from the coolness and their body will be warm. And also they used to have four limbs like us, like how we are having the hands and the legs like that. The mammals also used to have the four limbs and they used to breathe through the lungs only, like us. They do have the lungs, so they used to breathe through the lungs. And also we can say that these used to, some of the mammals used to fly very easily, like monkeys, due to their tail and all. It is used, they can used to fly, means they can used to jump from one place to another place. So this is about the mammals. Children, so with this part we have completed our animal kingdom. Understand ma? If you have any doubts, you can ask me, you can call to me personally and you can ask me. Thank you.